Amid high fuel costs, the monthly cash subsidy for poor Filipino families will be increased to 500 pesos. President Duterte gave the order to the Finance Department. Following clamor, the initial 200 peso cash aid is not enough to cover the basic needs of families. The government is now making the necessary preparations for the distribution of the subsidy.
Tayo po ay nakikipag-ugnayan sa kasulukuyan sa Department of Finance hinggil nga sa ayuda na ipapamahagi natin sa ating mga kababayang mahihirap. Gayun din po kasulukuyan nating inaantabayanan ang opisyal na kasulatan kasama po yung pondo na ibababa ng Department of Budget and Management para makapag-umpisa na tayo sa pamamahagi ng tulong na ito. And at the meantime, binabalangkas na ng DSWD yung mga panuntunan nito upang matiyak natin na magiging maayos at mabilis yung pamamahagi ng subsidy.
Sabi naman ng Pangulong Duterte ay gawin ang lahat para makakuha ng pondo. Kung ano mang paraan yon, kailangan makabuo tayo ng 500 pesos sa kada beneficiary.
Philippine President Rodrigo Duterte warns the Philippines could get caught in the crossfire if the conflict between Russia and Ukraine escalates. He claims China could also invade the Philippines during the chaos.
The name of the game is pressure. It will end only if Putin wants it or is taken out. And if by unfortunate chance, perchance, talagang maipit si Putin at tusukin niya yung pula na botones, wala na. Then my thinking is, pag mag-ganon yan, ang China will invade. Pero sa intelligence briefing, tatamaan talaga tayo.
Duterte also asserts he's friends with Russian President Vladimir Putin. But he says there's a difference between the two of them.
Kaibigan ko si Putin, pero sunobra. Ang pinapatay ko, kriminal. Si Putin binubumba pati babae, bata, lahat na. O sino man pinatay ko dito na para man sa inyo yan, para sa inyong mga anak, hindi man para sa... What do I get?
President Duterte also admits government cannot do anything to address skyrocketing fuel prices. He tells public utility drivers not to complain, saying fuel costs are high not only in the Philippines but also across the world. Duterte has rejected calls to suspend excise taxes on fuel as it would reduce government revenues by billions of pesos.
Baski sa anong sa protesta ninyo, yan talaga ang presyo ng langis. Ang supply ng oil kulang, tapos ang pera natin, mawala ng visa rin because we are not productive anymore because of the lack of fuel. Huwag kayo, kayong mga driver, pati everyone, huwag kayong maghinakit na tumataas ang presyo. Lahat ng sa mundo tinatamaan ngayon. Now, tayo, hindi ko masabi na mabababa ang gasolina ngayon. Wala tayong magawa. And every day, tumataas yung kasi ang supply doon sa bibili natin na humihina na, wala na silang makuha.
U.S. President Joe Biden says Russian President Vladimir Putin is considering to use biological and chemical weapons against Ukraine. Biden made that statement Monday without citing evidence, saying Putin's accusations that Kyiv and Washington have these weapons are a clear sign he's considering using them. Earlier this month, Russia's defense ministry accused Kyiv of planning a chemical attack against its own people so it can blame Moscow. It also alleged Washington is running a chemical weapons program in Ukrainian laboratories. Both Ukraine and the U.S. denied this. Ukrainian President Volodymyr Zelensky insists on meeting Vladimir Putin to negotiate an end to the war. Zelensky says he'll also raise the issue of Russian-occupied territories in Ukraine and try to come up with a solution. But he says any compromises agreed on with Russia to end the conflict will need to be voted on by Ukrainians in a referendum. Issues that could be raised in that referendum could cover territories occupied by Russia, including Crimea, and security guarantees offered to Ukraine by countries in lieu of a NATO membership. Russia's invasion of Ukraine stirs fears within NATO that a new Iron Curtain could fall across Europe, dividing its Baltic members from the rest. Here's the full story.
Hours after Russia's attack on Ukraine began, 5 German warships set sail for Latvia to help protect the most vulnerable part of NATO's eastern flank. Russia's invasion has propelled the alliance into what Secretary General Jens Stoltenberg has called a new normal. It looks a lot like the past. NATO was founded in 1949 to defend against the Soviet threat. Now a new Iron Curtain could fall across Europe. NATO needs to ensure its members are not behind it if it does. NATO has expanded eastward since the 1990s, bringing in former Soviet states such as Latvia, Lithuania and Estonia, where these French troops disembarked last week. A single overland corridor connects them to the rest of NATO territory, and it's squeezed between the heavily armed Russian enclave of Kaliningrad and Moscow ally Belarus. An emboldened Russia could encircle the Baltic states and cut them off from the rest of the alliance. That's where the Latvian mission comes in, a regular mine-clearing exercise that was brought forward by Russia's invasion. One goal is to keep the waterway open. The other is a show of strength. This was German naval commander Terje Schmidt-Eliasson on board the Elbe in Riga's harbour.
We'll be 12 units from 6 countries, and we are essentially showing our presence in the eastern Baltic.
Direct confrontation between NATO and Russia could touch off a global conflict. One retired NATO commander told Reuters the alliance is considering whether deterrence is enough. Not, according to Lithuanian Foreign Minister Gabrielius Landsbergis last week.
We are convinced in the Baltic states that we need to move from deterrence to a standing defense, and has to come from NATO planning leadership. That they would start looking into the region differently than they had throughout the last 2 decades.
Since the invasion, NATO allies have also moved 5 aircraft carriers into European waters, increased the number of warplanes in NATO airspace, and more than doubled the size of combat units in the Baltics and Poland. NATO also faces a return to mechanized warfare and a huge increase in defense spending.